wanted to say a big shout out. Can't wait to see you back. This is a little different, this video. It's about stress relief. It's about stretching, elongating your muscles, doing what you can, have fun with it. Anyway, here we go. We're just gonna check our postures. Shoulders are up and back. Open up that chest. Tummy's nice and tight. And you've got a grapefruit between your chin and your chest, making for a nice long neck. All right, you're gonna listen to your breathing. Breathing in through your nose. And loudly, audibly breathe out through your mouth. Again, you're gonna listen to your breathing throughout the stretch so that your muscles are being well oxygenated. We're gonna start off into a wide-legged stance. And now we're just gonna turn both our toes to face the opposite direction. And now with that back heel pushed down to the floor, we're gonna do a nice old-fashioned runner's lunge, bending that front knee. And if you're not feeling challenged here, you can step a little further back, keeping that heel to the floor, stretching in the calf and the upper hamstrings. And now we're gonna multitask it by taking those hands out front. Come right back. Roll the shoulders up and down and lift that chest towards the sky. You can also deepen your stretch by letting your head fall back onto your spine, lifting that chin to your ceiling. And now close your mouth to get a nice deep stretch in your jaw. Again, challenge yourself to a nice wide-legged lunge. Once you're in place, bend that front knee, keeping the heel down. Hips are square, shoulders are square. And now we'll do the same for our back as we just did for our chest. And we're going to take those hands straight out front of our chest. Interlock your fingers, push the palms away from you, pulling those shoulder blades apart. And now dropping that chin to your chest. And listening to the ebb and flow of your breath. Make sure your toe and heel are in alignment with one another. The weight of your head is the stretch, so let that chin fall a little bit further if you can. Shoulder blades back into their pockets, straighten that front leg, hinge at the hips, and bring it into a triangle pose in yoga, or just reach for the floor, looking at the kneecap, keeping that back flat. Flat back, and just hold and enjoy that stretch. body hang like a rag doll. Let the chin stay where it is. Check your posture. And now you're going to roll your head over to one side, keeping your chin to your chest. Let the ear fall to the shoulder. And if that's not enough, you can put a gentle pressure on the outside of your head. Gentle. Don't press. Just gentle pressure. Feels good. Let your head fall. And now you're going to take your eyes to look up at the ceiling. Your ear is still over to one shoulder. Hips are stacked over your ankles, your shoulders are stacked over your hips, your vertebrae are stacked over top of one each other, over each other. Excellent, and bring it back up. Let's do the same on the other side. Let the ear fall to the shoulder. Gentle pressure on the top of that head. And also take the other arm and push the hand away from the shoulder. It just lengthens your traps. And now you're going to roll your head so you're looking down at the floor, keeping that ear over to one side. Let the weight of your head be the stretch. Relax, breathe, be in the moment. If you are close to your bed, you can use your bed, you can use your couch, or you can use the floor for our next set of stretches. So we're going to take it down onto our backs. Let's try and get rid of the small space between your lower back and the mat or bed. So you're just going to feel that space, and now you're going to adjust your seat bone so it's gone. You're going to take one leg in the air, and we're going to grab behind the calf, not behind the knee. Nice straight leg with a soft knee. And we're going to rotate that ankle. 3, 2, 1. Other direction, please. And now we're going to point and flex. Take that same foot, place it across the knee, bring the other leg up off the floor, and what I call threading the needle, you're going to put your hand between your legs, clasp behind your hamstring, and pull, so your tailbone actually comes up off the floor. Untangle yourself. And let's do the same to the other side. Grab behind the calf, rotate that ankle. Other direction. Point and flex. And take that ankle, place it across the knee, and thread the needle, lifting the tailbone. Pull that foot towards your chest. You can also rock a little bit back and forth, side to side. A nice massage for your spine. Untangle yourself. Put your hands behind on your hamstrings and rock yourself up into a sit position with your feet out front. Coming to an easy pose. Sitting up nice and tall. We're just going to hinge at the hips, flat back, bring your chin and chest to your legs. When you're down as far as you can go, grab hold of your shins, calves, and now give it a pull down. Aiming to bring that chin right to your knee. Yeah, right? Now.